Yes. What do you understand by Whitaker's five kingdom classification? We covered in previous period Whitaker's five kingdom classification. So what is Whitaker's five kingdom classification? Varia Javed. It is a classification of five living organisms. No. Salama Ghalib, yes. Your voice is. Voice is not clear. Keep your mic mute. Five kingdom classification. What do you understand with this term? Five kingdom. Five kingdom. Categorization of the all organisms into five categories. They divided into five broad categories. That is called five kingdom classification, and that is given by Whitaker. Means Whitaker categorized all the organism into five categories. Understood? Faria Javed, yes, am I audible to you, Faria Javed? Okay, tell me the name of the five kingdoms that is given by Whitaker. Yes, fungi, plantae, animalia, plantae. Okay, protista. Yes, so they are the means organisms are categorized into five broad categories, that is Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae and Animalia. And who categorize? Whitaker categorize. So what are the characteristic on which or what is the criteria on which Whitaker characterize categorize the organism into five categories? Yes, Afshan. Oh yeah, one at a time, one at a time. Okay, Afshan, you tell me. I ask from Afshan. I ask from Afshan. Yes. Okay, tell. Yes. Waalaikum assalam. Now you join the class. Now you join the class. Your voice is not clear to me. Your voice is not clear to me. Say again. Say again. Yes, it depend on complexity of cell structure. Yes, it's based on complexity of cell structure, complexity of body organization and mode of nutrition. So cell structure, whether it is prokaryotic or eukaryotic. So Muhammad Abdullah, tell me, what does it mean, prokaryotic? What do you understand with this term, prokaryotic? Mohammed Umar raised hand. Yes, you, what do you want to say? You want to say something? Okay, tell me quickly. Prokaryotic. Wait. Prokaryotic. All of you repeat. Prokaryotic. 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 Yes. Yes, prokaryotic. Prokaryotic. And eukaryotic. Okay. हाँ, नाउ टेल मी. यस हाँ, यस टेल मी व्हाट इज प्रोकैरियोटिक क्विकली. यस ऑल ऑफ यू डोंट स्पीक ऑल ऑफ यू एट द सेम टाइम. Organisms. No. Yes, that is. When he started categorizing the organism, he took this point that how what type of cell is it prokaryotic or eukaryotic. So he categorized the organism prokaryotic in one and eukaryotic in another category. So he categorized separately prokaryotic as well as eukaryotic. So one point is this, another is complexity of body organism. Means whether the body is unicellular or multicellular. So he categorized at the time of categorization, he kept this point that the unicellular organism should be in separate category and multicellular organism they should be in separate category. So when he was doing work, he just kept unicellular separately and multicellular separately. So he was working on this criteria also, that complexity of body organization and then mode of nutrition. He kept autotrophic organism in one category and heterotrophic in one, means he is not intermixed. He kept separately autotrophic and heterotrophic. Understood? So autotrophic, heterotrophic, they are separate in separate category. and unicellular and multicellular, they are in separate categories. And he, of course, categorized the thing on the basis of whether they are prokaryotic and eukaryotic. Understood? And he kept one category for the organism which are having characteristic of both plant and animal, that is fungi. Because fungi having characteristic of both plant and animal. What you have not understood, beta? Prokaryotic means when the nucleus is not well defined, properly formed. When the nucleus is not prominent, means just this genetic material, it is embedded in the cytoplasm. Nuclear membrane is not there, nucleolus is also not there. And just single strand of DNA, circular single strand of DNA is there in the prokaryotic cell. And you just have to understand the point where the nucleus is not well defined, where the nucleus is not well formed. So prokaryotic cells, when the nucleus is not well defined, when it's not properly formed. Eukaryotic, where the nucleus is properly formed, where the nucleus is well defined. This is the difference between eukaryotic and prokaryotic. Understood? So now there is no confusion regarding it. Good. So we take or categorize the organism on the basis of three criteria: complexity of cell structure, complexity of body organization, and mode of nutrition. Now let's start kingdom Monera, because we take or categorize organism into five category, that is Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, and Animalia. Let's start Monera. So the term Monera originates from the Greek word monier, and which means single or solitary. Means Monera is actually the single cell organism. In this category, single cell or unicellular organisms are categorized. So here, the word moniris, from that only the Monera originate. Moniris, okay. So what does it mean? Single or solitary. Single, so the organism which are categorized in the Monera, they are single cell. So in this category, prokaryotic organism, they are categorized. Unicellular prokaryotic. Microscopic, we know that the cell is microscopic structure, cell is tiny structure. So in Monera, unicellular prokaryotic organisms are categorized, and they can be seen only with the help of microscope. They cannot be seen with the naked eye. So all the bacteria, they are grouped in kingdom Monera. So they are the primitive organisms. They are not having well defined nucleus. So all the unicellular prokaryotic organisms, they are categorized in kingdom Monera. So which organisms are categorized in kingdom Monera, Yasir Raza? Just tell me. Which type of organisms are categorized in kingdom Monera, Yasir Raza? Am I audible to you?